the jazz image, rolling along. The time and the music is in his hands. Introducing Red Norvo and his mallets. With guitarist Bucky Pizzarelli, pianist Russ Kassoff, bassist Jerry Bruno. Music is in his hands, and that's Red Norvo, a theme by Irving Berlin, and it's titled All of Me, from a new release on Stash, and recorded, as we have noted from the past weeks, in August of 1983 in New York City. Red Norvo's recent work and evidence of his high skill and ability. And here he is, with the sound of the vibraphone, his very special sounding and structure of music. And here's a little more to make the world go round. A Blues for Red, written by Bucky and John Pizzarelli. And this is the way it sounds. There's a quiet and yet pulsing kind of feeling to all of this. And these skilled artists are in charge. That was A Blues for Red, Jay Pizzarelli, Bucky, composing A Blues for Red Norvo and featuring his vibraphone and the guitar of Bucky Pizzarelli. The album, once again, is Just Friends, featuring Red Norvo, under the heading of Quality, Ni Plus Ultra. Red Norvo, one of the giants of this particular area. The instrument is the vibraphone. You, of course, have collided with Lionel Hampton, who is much more percussive. Norvo has a controlled and quiet way about him, but it has, in addition to that quiet control, great speed and change of pace. From 1983, let's go back to the year 1945. In the month of May, Red Norvo, teaming with Slam Stewart, Johnny Guarneri, Bill Duranjo, and Maury Feld. A session with Red and this sterling crew. Vintage 1945, and of course, the technology is not the best, but the music is there, with Norvo and this group, with an earnest group, dedicated musicians, Johnny Guarneri at piano, Maury Feld drums, Slam Stewart bass, and Bill Duranjo guitar. That theme was entitled, On the Upside, Looking Down. Now there's a point of view. As we hang upside, looking down, here's what we see. Over the landscape, hundreds of kites sort of bobbing in the air, part of the April viewpoint, and they're floating along with balloons everywhere, glowing, and attached to them are strings of baseballs and bats. A Louisville slugger glowing overhead. That's what we see on the upside, looking down. ¶¶ those standards in the jazz books and in the theater books, Time on My Hands. Red Norvo, with time in his hands, delivering these performances. Rexy Stewart, that master cornetist, broadcaster, and discerning critic who appeared with Duke Ellington's band for many years, wrote a book called Jazz Masters of the 30s. And Stewart, in that book, recalled an incident, an afternoon where his friend, guitarist Bernard Addison, came bursting into Big John's saloon in Harlem. The guitarist was raving about the incredible musician on a most unlikely instrument he'd just heard with Paul Whiteman. And the place was Paterson, New Jersey. Well, this is New York, uptown Manhattan. And Stewart and a couple of other skeptics instantly decided it was something they had to hear for themselves. Well, it meant a long, as Stewart recalled, complex trip via public transportation to Paterson from Big John's saloon. And it was snowing, Rexy Stewart recalled, as if God wanted to get this blizzard over in a hurry. But that didn't stop us, Stewart said. Finally, we arrived at the theater where Whiteman's band was appearing. And featured in the band, sure enough, was a swinging xylophone player named Red Norvo. Red was only given the solo spot on one number. But that was enough to set our hearts thumping, Rexy Stewart recalled, and our heads nodding in agreement. This cat had it. This was 1931 or so. The sessions you've listened to were recorded in 1983 and 1945. The Art of the Mallets and Red Norvo. And now the blues, and one of those unexposed and undiscovered people. If in the 50s you were rounding North Beach in San Francisco and the 60s, you dropped into one bistro or another, you might discover this voice. It belongs to Barbara Dane. So any of you who are San Franciscans or those Los Angelinos among us might recall seeing Barbara Dane in either one of those two locations. She's originally from Detroit.
I love my man, tell you reason why. He's got that certain kind of look in his eye. Oh, when I met him, he was nice and sweet. Lay down, Daddy, won't you take your rest? Call you through the night, I want you to do your best. I'm asking you, why do you do me like you do? Double, double, do love you. Ah, take it slow and easy if you wanna get along with me. Take it slow and easy, easy as any man can be. I got a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 a reason. Cross me, that's an act of treason. Take it slow and easy if you wanna get along. Double cross me, that's an act of treason. Take it slow and easy.
All the way from the West, Barbara Dane, and it's good to rediscover her. An out-of-print Capitol recording. She shouts and she wails, and that was Jesse Fuller's music and Take It Slow and Easy. She's backed by the legendary Duke Ellington bassist, Wellman Bro, and featuring Kenny Whitson at piano. The drummer on this date could be, Rocco Wilson or Billy Strange. We're not quite sure which one. Barbara Dane, for some of you who've haunted North Beach in San Francisco, she has corn silk yellow hair and a feeling for the blues that is compared to Ma Rainey, Bessie Smith, Mama Yancey, and her work at keyboard in the San Francisco area particularly is part of her own solo act. Here she has expert accompaniment and the slick facilities of Capitol Tower in Los Angeles.
I'm on my way.
She shouts and she wails. That was Barbara Dane, and a spiritual and gospel feeling on the theme, I'm on my way. Supporting cast here is the gospel-singing Andrew Sisters, not to be confused with the pop-singing Andrew Sisters. These Andrew Sisters come from Berkeley, California. The other Andrew Sisters come from Minnesota. At any rate, that was Barbara Dane, assisted by Kenny Whiston, who simultaneously, his left hand works the piano and his right hand works the coronet. And with left hand and right hand, he adds the color to the spirit of this recording. Barbara Dane, a rather rare and undiscovered kind of entertainer and artist in the field of the blues and gospel. And a rare out-of-print we discovered in a bin in a store miles away. So here it is. And here's an encore for those of you who admire and remember Barbara Dane.
broken, weary. But I try to be bright and cheery, having your fun, dragging my heart around. Well, things that you do, I try not to notice. People all see and they know who the goat is, having your fun, dragging my heart around. Now I smile all the time, and you treat me like an old stranger. But I won't get you up. I'm gonna be like a dog in the manger. I'm not a fool, but how can you blame me? So deep in love, dragging my
Barbara Dane, working her way through a composition by Alex Hill, and a bluesy thing, Dragging My Heart Around. No matter how blue it is, Barbara Dane always manages to give it a completely optimistic view. Once again, a tribute to Barbara Dane, whom Ebony Magazine ranked her with historic blues singers Ma Rainey and Mama Yancey. And in one report years ago, Ebony commented that this pale-faced young lady really keeps the hope and the spirit of blues alive. Barbara Dane, have any of you by chance heard her lately? Please let us know. Write to the Jazz Image, Minnesota Public Radio, 45 East 8th Street. The kinetic impact of Barbara Dane. Last week in jazz history. Recorded April 10th, 1962. An historic session, undiscovered by most of you, and from the file of Ray Markland, the team of Benny Carter, Ben Webster, Barney Bigard, along with a trumpet player by the name of Shorty Chirac. Shorty Chirac is a product of Minneapolis. He was born in Minneapolis in November of 1915. A trumpet and cornetist who played with Ben Pollock and Harry James and Tommy Dorsey. He's also on this date, along with the combination of Benny, Ben, and Barney. Thank you. Last week in jazz history, on April 10th in 1962, Leonard Feather recording Benny, Ben, and Barney. And there's much more to that supporting cast. Benny Carter, alto saxophone, Ben Webster, tenor, Barney Bigard, clarinet. Shorty Chirac on trumpet, and we noted to you that Shorty originally comes from Minneapolis, where he was born in 1915 in the month of November. And Jimmy Rolls featured piano, Leroy Vinegar bass, Dave Barber guitar, Mel Lewis drums. And that was the opening blues, a theme that originally was created by Leonard Feather as part of a background for a Langston Hughes poetry with jazz concept.
Thank you.
Benny Carter leading the way here, his melody, and a theme entitled Lula. Benny Carter's melody, and featuring his alto saxophone, along with Shorty Chirac on muted trumpet, Ben Webster on tenor saxophone, and this rhythm section that has that swinging 4-4 that romps along with a great deal of spirit and feeling. Mel Lewis, the timekeeper, drummer, Dave Barber, guitarist, Leroy Vinegar, bass, Jimmy Rolls, piano, and Benny Carter leading the way. Benny, Ben, and Barney and Company. A rare out-of-print label called Status Records, and from the files of Ray Markland, a look back in time to April 10th, 1962, when this session was recorded by Leonard Feather under his direction. And here it is, preserved for all time. The essence of swing here in this chapter of Last Week in Jazz History. Our thanks to Ray Markland. We have banners and labels for different departments and features of this electronic journal. And this next one, if you were to look at it visually, is just headline, new issue and reissue.
Thank you.
Ahmad Jamal, featured at keyboard, and that was a composition entitled Without You. Jamal supported here by Manola Badrina, he on percussion, and Herlin Riley, jazz drums, James Kamick bass, and Ahmad Jamal at piano. The composition, Without You, is from a new collection on the Atlantic Atco label, Jamal and Rossiter Road. Titled theme there is Rossiter Road. And this, some very new material created by Ahmad Jamal, in fact recorded in New York in the month of February this year. Jazz all night long on these member-supported radio stations. And my name is Leigh Kamman.